हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स. सो जनरली व्हाट इज पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स? सो इन अ पीरियोडिक टेबल हाउ इट इज डिवाइडेड? इट इज द पीरियोडिक टेबल इज डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर पार्ट्स. सो वन इज दिस इज एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स. दिस इज द मिडिल पार्ट, वी कॉल इट एज D block elements. This is P block. This is D block elements. And coming to at the bottom, we are having A block elements. Yes or no? So like this only, the periodic table is divided. S block, P block, D block, and F block elements we are going to divide. So coming to here, we are going to speak today is P block elements. So what is P block elements? So here the P block is nothing but here the P block elements. The P block is situated at the situated on the extreme right side, extreme right in the periodic table, we call it as P block elements. So what is P block elements? In a periodic table, the P block elements is situated on the right side of the periodic table. So this one we call it as what? P block elements. So here P block elements is also defined as the last electron or the last electron is occupied by P orbital is known as what? Is known as P block elements, we can say. So whatever the last electrons we are taking, so this last electron is occupied by P orbital, we call it as P block elements, we can say. So here the general electronic configuration, what we are going to have here for P block elements, the general electronic configuration for P block elements is NS2 NP128. So this is NP126. Okay, so what I have told, the last electron enter into outermost orbit, we call it as P block elements. So generally here the electronic configuration, the general electronic configuration for P block elements is what here? NS2 NP126, we call it as general electronic configuration. So these P block elements, what will happen? These P block elements, the P block elements consists of the P block element consists of six groups, that is what here, six groups, we call it as 13th group elements, 14th group elements, 15th group elements, 16th group elements, 17th group and 18th group elements. So what we can say here, the P block element consists of 6 groups. What is that 6 groups? 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 group elements. So generally it will occupy one order. The order for P block elements, we can say, p block elements is 8 comma 18 comma 18 comma 32, we can say. Okay, so 8 comma 18 comma 18, this will follow the order of the p block elements. Now let us see 13th group, 14th group, 15, 16, 17th group elements. So if you have been seen here, what are the elements of the 13th group elements? So 13th group elements, we call it as 3a group elements also. We can say 13th group or 3a group elements. So what are the elements we have seen? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Okay, so boron is having atomic number 5. So this general electronic configuration is ns2 np1, we can say. Okay, so here boron is atomic number 5. 5 plus 8, 13. 13 plus 18, 31. 31 plus 18, 49. 49 plus 32, 81. So I have told you order of p block elements is, so leaving starting elements, so say from second element onwards it will follow one order, that is 8 18 18 32. So in case if you don't know the atomic number, you can follow this order. Means if suppose first element you remember the atomic number, from second element onwards you can add. So what I have told you, for boron it is having 5 atomic number. Okay, so coming to aluminium, if you add 5 plus 8, the atomic number for aluminium is 13. And for gallium, 18 if you have been at, it will be having 31. For indium it is having 49. And for thallium 32, it will be having 81. So like this, if you have been following the order, so this is nothing but 13th group elements. And coming to 14th group elements, or we can say 4a group elements, so it is having general electronic configuration is ns2 npt. So what are the elements? We can say carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead. So this one we call it as boron family, this one we call it as carbon family. Okay, so coming to here 15th group elements, so 15th group elements, or we can say here 5a group elements, it is having ns2 np3 configuration. It may exhibit plus 3 oxidation state or plus 5 oxidation state. So what are the elements here? We are having nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth we are having. Coming to 16th group, we can say 6a group elements, so it is having general electronic configuration is ns2np4. So this is also called as chalcogens. So this one we call it as oxygen family, or we can say chalcogens. Group 16 elements we call it as chalcogens or oxygen family. So in 16 group we are having the elements is oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. Okay, so next one, 17th group elements we call it as 7a group elements, or the general electronic configuration is ns2np5. So this one we are having halogen family, we can say, or we can say this is a 7a group element. So what are the elements we are having here? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetone. Coming to 18th group, or we can say 8a group elements, so this is having complete octet configuration ns2 np6. So what are the elements we are having? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So these elements also known as, these elements we call it as here, so these elements is known as zero group elements. Okay, or noble gases, noble gas elements, or we can say inert gas elements. So 8a group elements we call it a zero group. Why we say zero group? It occupies complete configuration. And coming to here, this is known as noble gas elements. So this is known as inert gas element. So this is nothing but what? P block elements. So the P block elements, we are having 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18th group elements. Okay. So now coming to here, if you have been observed here, the valency. Okay, if you have been observed the valency for 13th group element or 3A group element. So for this, all the valency will be NS2NP1 means 3. So what I have told you, 13th group or 3A. So the group number is equals to this valency for this one. And coming to 14th group also, it will exhibit valency for this one. 15 also this one, means the group number is equals to the atom. Okay. And also the elements of this group is equals to the, if you have been seen, everything is like that. Okay. But coming to here, 3, 4, 5 group. Is equal to valency of this group number, we can say, if you have been observed here, all are equal to group number. If you have been seen clearly, the valency, the outermost electrons, if you have been observed, what are the general configuration? NS2NP3, NS2NP2. But coming to here, phosphorus can exhibit +3 also oxidation state. Oxygen can exhibit +4 also. So one thing we can say, 8 minus group number, if you have been taken, so 8 minus group numbers, if suppose I'm taking phosphorus, phosphorus is having NS2NP3 means 5. So what is its group number? 5 here. So 8 minus 5, it will exhibit 3. So it can exhibit +3 oxidation state and also +5. So to find the valency, 8 minus group number you can take, or you can see that it should be equal to the group number only. So this is nothing but general introduction of the P block element. Now we are going to discuss each group elements according to their properties and their basic natures, acidic natures, and the topics we are going to discuss. So in P block elements, we are going to discuss here is 13th group elements. Okay, today we are going to discuss what here, 13th group elements. This is your first unit, first lesson. So first unit, first lesson is what here, 13th group elements we are going to discuss today. So generally, what is 13th group elements? So means what here? What is 13th group element? The electron enter into p orbital, we call it as p block element. So what are the elements we are taking here? What are the in 13th group we are having? Boron, the symbol is p, atomic number we are having 5. So what is its electronic configuration we are having? 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So what is its outermost electron? 2s2, 2p1. So means what? The general electronic configuration, the general electronic configuration for 13th group elements is 2s2 NP1. Okay, so here next element what we are having, aluminium. So Al, the atomic number is 13, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. Next one what we can say here, gallium. So gallium indicates what the symbol here? The gallium symbol is Ga. Atomic number what we can say? 49. What is its electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p1. Okay, now coming to indium. So what is next element? Indium. The symbol is In. Atomic number 49. So it is having electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 5s2, 5p1. Now next coming to thallium. Thallium is having electron symbol Tl, atomic number 81. So the electronic configuration will be here 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 5s2. And here having 4f14 also orbital, 5p6, 5d10, 6s2, 6p1. So this is about general electronic configuration. If you have been observed here, the outermost electron is 2s2 2p1, 3s2 3p1. The last electron, the general electronic configuration is what? ns2 np1. If you have been observed here, so at last what we are observing? s2 p1. So means what will be the valency will be for all the elements? So the for all the elements, the valency will be here how much? The valency will be plus 3 will be the valency of its boron family. So this one we call it as boron family also. So these are the elements it is present. If you have been seen the order, so boron is having atomic number 5. If you add 8, 13 we are having. If you add 18, we are getting the 31 is the atomic number. 49 is also atomic number if you add 18, and it is having 32 if you add 81. So this is nothing but elements we are taken. So this is nothing but symbol. This is atomic number. So this is electronic configuration. So in this lesson, what are the topics we are going to discuss? Here is nothing but here. So we are discussing about general properties, properties of 13 group elements, that is atomic radius. So what are the things we are going to discuss here is atomic radius, melting, boiling point and density we are going to discuss. General properties is nothing but these are the things we are going to discuss in this. Ionization energy, electron negativity, electron enthalpy, alloy formation, sometimes we are going to discuss color formation also, and we are going to discuss oxidation states. With properties, definitions and also nature of the compounds we are going to discuss. Nature of compounds we are going to discuss. So atomic radius or ionic radius is same. So these are the properties we are going to discuss, with reasons we are going to discuss in this lesson, and also we are going to discuss diborane and borazan structure, preparation and properties. So in this lesson we are going to speak about general properties and preparation properties and structure of the diborane and borazan. So this is about general introduction class of first unit, first lesson. So this is about general introduction of P block elements. In the next class we can discuss about the properties. Thank you.